The formation of pond during the fetal stage of development occurs by two processes, intramembranous ossification and endochondral ossification. Intramembranous ossification mainly occurs during the formation of the flat bones of the skull as well as the mandible, maxilla and clavicles. The bone is formed from connective tissue such as mesenchyme tissue rather than from the cartilage. The steps in the intramembranous ossification are the development of ossification center, calcification, formation of trabeculae, development of periosteum. Endochondral ossification begins with points in the cartilage called primary ossification centers. They mostly appear during the fetal development, though a few short bones begin their primary ossification after birth. These cartilage points are responsible for formation of the diaphysis of long bones, short bones, and certain part of irregular bones. Secondary ossification, it occurs after birth and forms the epiphysis of long bones and the extremities of irregular and flat bones. The diaphysis and both epiphyses of a long bone are separated by a growing zone of cartilage. When the child reaches skeletal maturity, 18 to 25 years of age, all cartilage is replaced by bone, fusing the diaphysis and both epiphyses together. Epiphyseal closure. Watch detailed lecture on SCADA.com histology course. That's 2 minutes. See you in the next video.